Hi, I'm Kendall Robert, and today we're going to learn how to solve systems of equations involving three variables. Now here we have three separate equations. Each of them has an x, y, and z variable in it. The trick to solving systems with three variables is to break them down into systems with just two variables, and then finally break them down into an equation with just one variable. So let's look at the first two equations. I notice that the coefficients of x are 4 and 2. If I multiply the second equation by negative 2, let's see what happens. So times negative 2, and I'll draw an arrow showing where the equation will be written. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4x plus 6y minus 10z equals 28. The top equation, I'm simply going to rewrite again. I'm not going to do anything to it. 4x plus 2y plus 3z equals 1. Now when I add these two equations, we notice that 4 and negative 4 are opposites. Whenever we have opposite coefficients, we can eliminate a variable. So let's do that to eliminate x. 4x plus negative 4x is 0x. Then we're left with 8y minus 7z equals 29. Now this is great. I now have an equation with just two variables in it. But one equation with two unknowns is unsolvable. So we need to find another one. Now I use these first two equations to produce this equation. I need to use two different equations to produce a separate equation that doesn't have x in it. So let's use the bottom two. This time I'm going to multiply the middle equation by negative 3. So I have negative 6x plus 9y minus 15z equals 42. Now the reason I did that is because now negative 6x is an opposite coefficient to 6x. So I'm going to rewrite the third equation, not going to do anything to it. When I add these two equations, I get 0x again plus 8y, and right here I get minus 11z, and finally 41. Now the good news is, let's look at these two equations. I now have two equations with only y and z in them. That's great. We can solve that. Let me rewrite the two equations I have right now. Now 8y and 8y are identical. They have the same coefficient. If I subtract these two equations, I'm left with 0y, and then I have negative 7z minus negative 11z. Well, that's the same as negative 7z plus 11, so I'm left with 4z. And down here, looks like I'm left with negative 12. Dividing both sides by 4, I find that z equals negative 3. Now I know what z is, and I can go back to either of these equations to determine what y is. I can do that by substituting in the value negative 3 for z. So let's do that to, well, let's use this equation. 8y minus 7, and instead of writing z, I'm going to write negative 3 equals 29. So I have 8y plus 21 equals 29. Subtracting 21 from both sides and dividing by 8, I can see that y equals 1. So at this point, I know z equals negative 3 and y equals 1. I just need to determine what x is. So if we go back to our original three equations, we can substitute in a z and our y and figure out what x is. Let's use the first equation. 4x plus 2, and instead of writing y, I'm going to write 1. Plus 3z, but instead of writing z, I'm going to write negative 3. And that all equals 1. Now let's do some algebra to figure out what x is. Minus 7 equals 1, add 7 to both sides, and we have 4x equals 8. Divide both sides by 4, and we finish with x equals 2. Now the best way to write our answer for x, y, and z is in the form of an ordered triple. That is, we write x, y, z. Similar to an ordered pair where we'd write the xy coordinates. So in this case, xyz equals 2, 1, negative 3.